Let's consider these two pool balls here. Ignore the arrows for right now. Just consider these two balls. If we take these balls and the mass of our combination of these balls remains constant, which is likely to do, and the net external force on the system is zero, then we have a closed system and our momentum is conserved, which means it stays constant in time. With pool balls, we can then consider a ball moving with some initial velocity, another ball moving with some other initial velocity. They can collide and end up with completely other velocities. But because that collision is all within our system, its force is being exerted from cue balls on one another and not from external things into our system, we can conserve momentum and write a conservation of momentum statement that relates our initial momenta to our final momenta. Here's another example. We've got two cars that collide. You could consider one car separately and then look at the impulse of action as it hits another car. Or we could combine these cars into one system and consider the combined momentum of the system, P1 plus P2, for the momentum of car 1 plus the momentum of car 2, as our total momentum. And then we consider the collision and say, as long as there's no net external force during this collision, then after the collision, we'll have the same total momentum of our system. Here it's using a prime to indicate our before and after. So it has P total before, and then P prime total after. I might use other subscripts to denote after or before, but this is a convenient way of doing it. With that idea of conservation of momentum, we can now solve problems, and in doing so, generally we'll start by identifying our system. And we want a closed system where our total mass is constant with no net external forces acting on it, so that we can write an expression representing the total momentum of the system before our event, explosion, collision, what have you. And we can write an expression representing the total momentum of the system after. Then we'll set those expressions equal to one another and solve for the thing we want to find. So that's the basics of using conservation of momentum to solve problems.